Hi, I'm Justin Allegri, and this is your Wednesday edition of Inside the Show. Looking first at the NL East, Jose Fernandez allowed nothing in his complete game shutout win as the Marlins took care of Detroit 3-0. The New York Mets allowed 5 hits in the game as they beat the Royals in Kauffman Stadium 8-2. The Giants took a victory against the...
It's another hot and muggy day in Miami, and the roof is closed as such for comfort at Marlins Park. Here we wrap up the homestand with the finale of this two-game series between the Detroit Tigers and the Miami Marlins. A big-time arm and a power bat should be fun. First pitch is next. Wei-Yin Chen gets the ball for Miami in this one. EK, what's the word on him?
Well, guys, last year he had an ERA of about 3.5. Very consistent. Really, he kept his ball club in the game every time he took the mound.
Jose Iglesias heads for the box, ready to lead this one off today.
Leading off the afternoon for Detroit, shortstop, Jose Iglesias.
Sends that one out of play for strike one. Chen gets the sign. Here he comes, 0-1. And a fastball way off target here, and it's even at 1. These Marlins, EK, as they take the field here this afternoon, they're coming off a good victory here in front of the home faithful on opening day.
Yeah, you don't want to feel like you're playing catch-up one game into the season, so getting that win in front of the big crowd was a good positive start to the season. Now they just need to carry that over into game two.
Ready on 1-2. A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. Breaks his bat as this one's popped up.
That ball was so deep in his kitchen, that was the only thing he could do was foul it off, break his bat, and hope to get a better pitch on the next one.
This one's blooped out toward right center field. Gordon ranging into shallow right. He's there and records the first down. So a moment now to take a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Detroit Tigers. Steve, what's their focus as they go for their first win?
Well, I think you really have to limit the strikeouts in this game. Don't have any wasted plate appearances, and we know that's easier said than done, but you also have to have your 3-4-5 hitters step up in this one somehow.
Justin Upton will stand in now following that 7-pitch at bat to begin the ball game.
If he was smart, he would have gotten a pretty good look at all 7 of those pitches from that on deck circle.
First delivery to him on the way. Starts him with a good rising fastball there for strike one.
And that's about where he'll sit with that fastball, 93, 94. And that's plenty hard enough to blow up by guys when you need to.
On the ground up the middle. And that is through into center field for a one-out single.
This is a little bit of a surprise in pitch selection here. I mean, the guy was just way late on the fastball to pitch before. Why throw something soft in the strike zone and speed up his bat? That's only doing the guy a favor.
Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Drifting toward the third base dugout, Realmuto has a play. He's got it, and there are two down now. And with that, let's give you a look at the Miami D. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric, what do we need to know?
Well, guys, Giancarlo Stanton, if you've ever had an opportunity to watch him take BP, go watch it because it is unreal. Defensively, you can watch that as well. He's got a very good arm, and he shows surprising athletic ability for a big man out there. We'll see what he does in this one.
J.D. Martinez stands in as he looks at ball one here. Seemed to quicken his delivery to the plate on that last pitch.
Well, you got to remember, the slide step does two things for you. It gets the catcher the ball quicker so he can throw a guy out, or it will hold the runner on first so he doesn't steal at all.
Runner's back.
Oh, he's in.
Two out with the man at first. The 1-0 delivery. Perhaps a little low there. It's 2-0. Looks like he employed the slide step on that last pitch.
Well, Matt, the pitcher may have thought the runner might be on the move right there, so he slide steps to hang on to him.
2-1 after the foul ball there. A runner on first with two away. And there goes Upton. Pitch inside, the throw, way late, and he's in there easily at second. And the good fastball there finds the zone as the count goes full now, 3-2.
Well, this is the kind of situation where they came up short last night. They had opportunities, but they could never really cash them in, so you can bet they'd love to get something going on the board early here.
And that's through into center field. Base hit. And now third base coach Dave Clark's giving him the come on around third. And they're going to take a 1-0 lead as the run comes across to score.
Batting fifth. Second
baseman. Ian Kinsler steps in to try and keep things going now with a runner at first following the RBI single.
And that's a nice job right there to drive in the run by the last guy. And it can definitely fire up a team when someone comes through big time with two outs.
And Ozuna will make the catch to retire the side. Tigers get one here. Justin Verlander, a Virginia-born right-hander, gets the ball to start this one. What's your take on him, EK?
Remember, guys, this is someone that will come at you with four different pitches. He'll change velocity, he'll go up and down, the break on the pitches makes it a real challenge for a hitter.
D. Gordon is in to start things off here as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. That's lifted the other way out to left. On the move is Upton. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. Time now for a glance at the Marlins lineup card in this one. Steve, how do they send these fans home happy here today?
Well, I think just putting this guy into the stretch early and often. Look to get the leadoff hitter on base to give themselves the best opportunity to score runs throughout the game.
Christian Yelich will dig in. 1-for-4 with a triple in last night's game. High in the air out to center field. Maben there to put it away for out number two.
Batting third.
Giancarlo Stanton gets his first cuts now. The bases are empty, and there are two away here in the opening frame.
Yeah, nothing doing so far here. He kind of needs to put up a tough at-bat right here just to make this guy work a little bit.
And here's a slider that runs inside that time, and that'll keep him from diving out over the plate.
Oof.
I'll tell you, you do not want to buzz this guy's tower.
And, oh, looked like ball two below the knees, but it's ruled a strike, and that evens the count at 1-1.
And after you move a guy off the plate, and you know he's all worked up, that's a perfect time to drop a curveball or a changeup on him. Great pitch call right there.
Swing and a little tapper. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Miami down in order. They trail this one 1-0. Nick Castellanos will stand in here, and like so many others, hitless in the shutout last night.
Well, when you have a rough day at the plate, it's all about letting it go. You can't dwell on it for too long.
Chin into the windup. Here comes the first pitch. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
And, you know, I think it's going to be important that when guys get their pitches, they take advantage. There it looked like he was taken all the way, and he may not get another pitch that catches that much of the plate.
And a base hit here to open up the second.
Batting seventh, the catcher number 34.
In now, James McCann, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Started to go around there, but he holds up ball one.
He just about went around. He was lucky to put on the brakes when he did.
Pitch to the plate is a slider for a strike, and it's all knotted up at 1-1. And set up working the plate is Larry Bullard, as you see the rest of our umpiring crew there.
Yeah, Bullard's got a pretty good strike zone all around. He'll miss a call every once in a while in the corners, but what umpire doesn't?
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Grounded up the first baseline, but a foul ball, 1-2 now. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Just inside, not by much. It's 2-2.
You know, I think you have to ask yourself, was he trying to throw a fastball for a strike right there? Or was he just trying to set me up for that changeup away?
And a check swing here, but the bat clearly breaks the plane as he set down for the first out.
Not too happy about that decision down there at first base. We're going to check it out again here on Show Motion. Boy, that is a tight call. You know, one way or another, someone wasn't going to be happy about that.
Here's Cameron Maben now, as he'll take a look at a strike right down the middle. It's 0-1.
And you know, you get stuck sometimes being that number 8 hitter trying to work the count and trying to buy a little extra time for your pitcher. Now that's a pitch right down the middle that maybe a number 4 hitter jumps all over.
Hit the other way out toward right field. Stanton waits on it, makes the play, and there are two gone now.
Well, the only good news that comes out of this at-bat is that he stayed out of the double play. Other than that, this at-bat really didn't achieve a whole lot.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Justin Verlander is next as he finds himself behind 0-1. The 0-1 pitch. Slow curveball. 75 on the radar. It's 0-2.
Well, no taking now. He's going to have to swing the bat.
Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Tigers leave one. We've played an inning and a half. It's 1-0. Leading off the inning, Justin Bour, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
And this is a guy that can make a big change in this game with one swing of the bat, because you know he has big-time power.
First pitch of the inning misses here to the cleanup man. It's 1-0. Chop foul right at home plate. It's strike one. Here's the 1-1 delivery. Right side. Kinsler's there for it, and he's retired here, one away.
Batting fifth, third baseman, Martin Prado.
Martin Prado will stand in. He comes off an 0-for-4 in last night's ball game.
Yeah, not really a great performance for him yesterday, but that's just part of this ball game. You have to know that those rough ones are going to come up and bite you every once in a while.
Iglesias is up with it. Throw on to first, and Verlander's got it going here. Two away.
Batting sixth, left fielder,
Marcelo Zuna will stand in, coming off a 2-home-run game a night ago. And boy, a high strike called there. That's not all that consistent, but it's strike one.
Yeah, you wonder if we're going to be seeing that high strike. That one looked to be above the letters, but not so in the eyes of the home plate umpire.
Not able to hold on there as he swings through a pitch in the dirt, and it doesn't look good for him now. Down 0-2. Pitch on the way. This ball sharply hit, but right to Iglesias at short. Pretty much right in the glove that time, and the inning is over. Back at Marlins Park for the third inning as we get a nice aerial view of Miami Beach's Art Deco district. Jose Iglesias will get a second crack at it here. He flied out to lead off the ball game.
You know, if there's any consolation, though, he saw a lot of pitches. So it's a good at-bat. Not the result he wanted, but a good at-bat.
Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing and one. A softly hit ball here, foul, off to the left side, and it's strike two now. Lifted in the air out towards left center. On the move is Ozuna. He tracks it down. A nice running play, and there's one away.
The left fielder, number 8, Justin Upton.
Justin Upton strides in after getting a base hit and later scoring the first time around. Chen's ready. First pitch on its way. And a slider that time as this ball's hammered to deep left field. And that is the definition of a mistake pitch there as this ball is gone. A home run. Justin Upton with the solo home run. And it's given Detroit a 2-0 lead. Miguel Cabrera is in for the second time here as he looks at a ball high 1-0.
And these guys already have one home run here in the inning. And now you get to the real power guys here. So you need to be careful.
Skied into straightaway right. Stanton has a read on it. Two down.
Now batting, right fielder,
J.D. Martinez will stand in. He took home a Silver Slugger Award for American League outfielders a year ago.
Yeah.
Now a slider, and he gets ahead of him here 0-1. Here's a breaking ball outside, and now it's even 1-1. And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. One for the Tigers, and it comes on this solo home run. We played 2.5, and it's now 2-0 Tigers. JT Realmuto will come forward to begin the inning. 7, 8, and 9 to start the home third.
And they're still searching for a base runner. It's been 6 up, 6 down to start the game.
And now a swing and a miss, and that's what you call establishing the inside part of the plate. It's strike one.
That got in his kitchen big time right there.
Hit hard towards second. But there to make the play is Kinsler as he takes away a knock. One gone.
The shortstop.
At the plate, Adani Echevarria. He'll get to take his first cuts here. In there, no balls and a strike.
You can tell here, in his mind, he's thinking, quick inning. He's not even trying to set guys up. He's coming right after him.
Barely able to make contact. Down 0-2 now. Line to the right side. But taken in over at first for the second out, as that might have been extra bases if it were 3 feet higher.
Still looking for that first hit of the ball game, and this one had the potential to be one, but it was not meant to be.
Wei-Yin Chen will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
And a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball.
Leave it to the pitcher to finally get him a base runner. He was eight up, eight down before he stepped in. And he's saying, what's so hard about this?
Here's D. Gordon now. Oh, and he lays one down here, and this is going to be a tough play. And the throw just does beat him at the bag, so the side is retired. Marlins leave one. They trail things here 2-0. Ian Kinsler is ready here as we begin the top of the fourth.
And they jumped out to that early lead, so now it's all about just adding on.
A ball hit hard to the left side, and that'll get down for a base hit. So he goes after the first pitch, and it's early trouble here this half of the inning.
As we look at that again, you know, this is not a bad pitch by any stretch. If he throws this pitch 10 times, I bet he gets him out 9 of them. But here you just have to tip your cap to the guy at the plate.
This is line to left. Ozuna is right there as he puts it away. No problem for the first down.
The catcher, number 30,
James McCann in now. He went down looking in his first trip to the plate.
Yeah, it's always a frustrating thing to go down looking. But you know what? Everybody does it. So you've got to let that one go and make the next AB count.
Just a bit late, and he's fallen behind 0-2. Chen sets. Here it is on 0-2. Hit sharply toward the right side. And that'll get down for a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Center fielder, number 4.
Cameron Maben is into the box for his second appearance. 0-for-1 with a flyout. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. He's set. Here it comes. And he gets ahead here with the fastball. Strike one. 2 runs, 6 hits. And no errors in the ballgame for the Tigers. Now a ball lined to the left side. Take something off, but it's 1-2 now. Where are you going here?
I'm throwing that same pitch again. Make him prove that his plate discipline is such that he can lay off it twice in a row.
Hit high in the air down the right field line. Stanton is over near the line now as he makes the catch for the second out of the inning.
And right here, you've got the right fielder shading just a bit towards the alley. And I thought he'd have too far to go to get this ball, but he does close quickly out there, and he makes the play near the line.
Stepping in now, Justin Verlander, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike.
And even though you got a 2-run lead, you don't want to be leaving too many guys in scoring position out there. That could come back to bite you later.
Stanton has a read on it, and the inning is over. Tigers strand a pair. They're up 2-0. Christian Yelich will get us started here for Miami, and he'll have backup in the form of Giancarlo Stanton waiting on deck.
And right here is an important time for them to climb back into this one. They definitely want to even this one up sooner rather than later.
A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0.
Yeah, looked like he hit the target. That's a tough pitch to lay off, but he made it pan out.
Had him fooled as this has popped up back behind short. There to take it is the sure-handed Iglesias, one away. So with that, let's call on the guys in the graphics department to put up the pitch speed comparison for the two starters. And both guys bringing it pretty good. A couple of matching 94s is the two top speeds thus far. Oh, and he leaves the fastball up there. Mistake in location. He is going to pay for it dearly as that ball is sent over the wall. A home run. It's a solo blast off the bat of Giancarlo Stanton. And the Marlins have made this a 2-1 game.
I tell you, that's the perfect storm there. A power pitcher on the mound throwing a hard fastball to a power hitter at the plate. He takes a big swing and squares it perfectly. I mean, that's as long a home run as you're going to see.
Now batting. First baseman.
Into the box, Justin Bour. Oh, he looks like he's swinging a garden hose out there as this is cut on and missed for strike one.
Boy, we're more than halfway through this game, and he's thrown a first pitch strike to 70% of the batters he's faced. So he's pitching very, very well right now.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Swing and a drive. This one's deep to right. Gone! They've tied the game on back-to-back home runs. Solo shot to right center as the Marlins have rallied back to tie it at 2 apiece.
You want production from the middle of your lineup? How about back-to-back home runs? I'd say that's production.
Third baseman number 14.
Martin Prado now.
Prado.
Oh, could it be three in a row? Ranging back is Maben. He gets there, and that's the second out.
And after the previous two balls left the ballpark, once this ball left the bat, he was probably thinking, oh, not again. But luckily for him, this one stays in the yard.
Marcell Ozuna stands in for the second time. Hit it hard but lined out in his first at-bat.
Yeah, he was pretty unlucky last time because he squared up that fastball nicely. So we're going to have to see if they still come out of it hard stuff.
That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
Boy, that hit right there is just a thing of beauty. You talk about smoking one right back at the box. There isn't too many guys in the middle of that field that can catch a ball like that.
Standing in now, JT Realmuto. Hit high and deep out there to left center field. Looking up is Upton. And that one is out of here. A two-run shot that gives them the lead. So a two-run shot to left center, and it stakes the Marlins to a 4-2 lead.
Boy, they are absolutely teeing off on him now. And that's your third home run here in this inning, and I got to think, that leash has got to be awfully short right now.
Here's Echeverria now.
Shortstop, Adamy.
Swing and a miss on a ball in the dirt, and it's strike one.
And it's hard to be patient sometimes when you see your teammates walking up there and having great at-bats. You want to get in on the act too, but you can't go helping a guy out.
Line towards center field, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Boy, they are really sticking it to him right here. That's the fifth hit he's coughed up in this inning alone. And you got to believe that that leash is getting a little bit shorter with each passing batter.
Wei-Yin Chen will dig in. He singled his first time around.
Yeah, he showed a little prowess with the bat last time, and they may have to pitch him a little bit tougher right here.
Goes the other way, and this is in the air out to left. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. So four runs in the inning, but of note there was that they came on the strength of three home runs. We played four full. The Marlins on top, 4-2. Jose Iglesias heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one.
And guys, this is the guy you want leading off this inning. He's your leadoff man, so maybe he can get things started. Set the table for a little bit of a rally.
High and tight here to begin the inning. It's ball one. Swing and a ball line hard towards short. Well, this will be taken in out there at short, and that's the first out of the inning.
Now after the four-run inning, we'll get to see if he approaches things any differently now that he's working with the league. You know, you figure the approach will be similar, but that's a good job anyway of getting the first out here.
Justin Upton stands in for the third time now as he takes a look at a ball. It's 1-0. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. Both teams with six hits so far. Slider taken for a called strike. 2-1. Drives it to deep right field. Back goes Stanton. And just short of a home run, this ball's off the wall. And he is in to second base with a double, his third hit this afternoon.
First baseman number 24.
Darn near at his second home run of the ball game. You see, this thing bangs off the wall out there. He's in to second with a double.
The first baseman Miguel Cabrera stands in as he'll swing here and lift a fly ball out to right center. Stanton has to come in from the next area code to put this one away. Wow.
Now batting.
J.D. Martinez will stand in now. He's singled and struck out in two trips. And they go right after him on the inside corner for strike one. And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
Yeah, and it seems like he kind of got away from that pitch here in the last few innings. You got to think about bringing that one right back.
Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. One left for Detroit. Still down by a count of 4-2. D. Gordon come in now to lead things off against our starter who probably wishes he had a mulligan to use on that last inning.
Yeah, he was doing just fine up until the last time he took the mound. He's got to hope that that was just an aberration, or he might not stick around to see another inning.
And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. Some action now in the Tigers' bullpen as they'll get a left-hander and a right-hander up to throw. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Maben on the run. And that's the first out of the inning.
Well, he gets you out there, but he's not missing many bats right now. The guys are really putting together some good swings against him so far.
Good swing. Just got to try and straighten that one out. Verlander sets his sights. Here's the 0-1. That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. 4-2 our score here as we play inning number five. Helping him out here as he swings and misses to fall behind a ball and two strikes. Shot. shot back up the middle. Maven is back, and he'll get there to make the play for route number two.
And he's finding the terrain much easier to navigate this time around. After that four-run inning, this is a guy who needs a quick inning here, and he's two-thirds of the way home.
First pitch of the at-bat. Back to him, and that's off his leg. Throw to first, but he's safe. And now the stadium's attention turns back to the man on the mound.
Jeez, how's he doing after that shot?
Boy, this one might be a case of adding injury to insult. It hasn't been his finest performance so far. And now this one shot right back at him at the mound. No time to get out of the way. And that's going to sting for quite a while.
Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. And you figure now this would be a spot where that man might try to take second base.
And it wouldn't be a bad idea to hold the ball a little longer out there on the mound. Really bury your times to the plate. You can't be predictable out there, or he'll take advantage.
And he misses low with it, 2-0.
And another good hitter's count to work with here. They've been able to sit back and just really tee off on him.
Too far out in front that time. He can't keep it fair, 2-1. He's running toward second. A shot down the first baseline. A dive, and he can't hang on. And a good effort as he's able to stick with it and get the third out of the inning. One left for Miami as they can't add to their 4-2 lead. Ian Kinsler steps in here to lead off the sixth as the rain continues to fall here.
Well, I'm glad I'm up in this cozy booth with you guys, because it kind of looks pretty miserable down there to me.
And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the...
What did you say?
Nick Castellanos digs in now after lining out in his last try.
Yeah, he put a good swing on him last time. So
what did you say?
Now a throw at the first, and he'll get back in safely.
Just keeping an eye on him.
And it's quickly 0-2. We're in the sixth inning now of a 4-2 ball game. Swing, and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And he's retired one away.
Yeah, a good pitch there as he gets the pop out on the fastball. As we take a look at his pitch breakdown so far.
James McCann will stand in. Strikeout victim his first time, and then a base hit last time around. Drilled on the ground is short. Step on the back of the line, and a bit of a high throw that time, but not much problem over there at first, as that will end the inning. One hit in the inning, but no one left. On to the bottom of inning number six. It's the Marlins 4 and the Tigers 2. Martin Pato will step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. Yeah, we see a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen up in the bullpen. Grounded to short. Iglesias is there. And on one pitch, he's retired.
Up next for the Marlins.
Marcell Ozuna steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Verlander gets the sign. Here's the first pitch.
Ooh, that's a little high. I don't think that's a strike, but I mean, whatever. the left. Upton is oh, he caught it? Wow. Much problem for the
second out. Well, I thought this might be his last inning out there, but it's only taken him three pitches to get two outs. Maybe not.
Into the windup and the pitch. Off the plate and low here, ball one. Four runs, seven hits, and no errors in the game for the Marlins. Lifted in the air to center field. Maven is in pursuit. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the shot. 1-2-3 go to Marlins. But they still lead this one 4-2. Cameron Maven is set to get us started for the late innings of this one. Chen's got his target. First pitch on the way. And a good pitch on the inside corner for strike one. He continues to get ahead here. He's been in complete control.
I think you need to guard yourself from being overconfident. A bloop and a blast could still turn this game on its ear.
That misses 1-2.
Not a real good 0-2 there. You don't necessarily want it in the zone, but you do want to at least give him something to think about.
Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Pulls this one in the air out to left. And the seventh inning starts with a flyout here, one away.
Now as this game goes along, you have to wonder whether or not this will be his last inning of work. He's due to bat second when their turn comes around.
And now the Marlins bullpen will swing into action.
Ooh, that was a little... Wow, I don't know where that shit missed.
This one's a strike. It's 1-1.
Yeah, showing no fear there. He put the pitch right at the letters away, but that guy didn't want any part of it.
And here's a ball lifted high into foul ground down the right field line. And the pinch hitter will not be able to advance the cause, and there are two away now.
Well, that's back-to-back curveballs right there, and he couldn't really square either of them up. And he's retired easily on the flyout.
Hit down the third baseline. Prado was
in a hurry. Throw on to Ooh, that was close. Holy shit.
Three up, three down for Detroit. They trail it here 4-2. Justin Wilson is out from the bullpen now as he'll be making his first appearance of this young season. Adani Echevarria digs in, coming off a single in his last at bat.
Well, everyone knows he's slumping right now, so we'll see if that got him going.
Oh!
Curveball, strike one.
Not a bad idea to take a look at that one there. Now that you've seen the curveball, you can start to get a better gauge on it. Get a feel for what it looks like coming out of the pitcher's hand.
On its way, the 0-1 pitch.
I jammed him.
Iglesias is there for it, one out.
Yeah, cut fastball right there. And that's exactly what it's designed to do. Keep that ball right off the sweet spot of the bat. That's going to turn into a little loop.
Wei-Yin Chen will buy himself another at-bat. And in turn, he'll get himself a nice little ovation for the work he's turned in on the mound so far.
Well, he's been great. This is an appreciative crowd. They like what they've seen, and I don't blame them.
Swing and a liner. Foul. Foul. Oh, and one count and the pitch. And this is hit hard up the middle.
Wow, that is unbelievable. Come on, Ichiro. Wow. Fucking. Give me 1 second. I want to change something on the broadcast. Thanks a lot, dude. I saw you subscribed. Appreciate it. I'll subscribe to your channel as well. And hell yeah, as far as opening day is concerned, I'm definitely looking forward to that shit. What's your favorite team?
Here's D. Gordon now.
That's what Steve does. Just a little ground ball here, but he's hustling all the way and beats it out for an infield single. Christian Yelich stands into the box. He could really use the knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far.
Wow. Come on, Yelich. Do something.
First pitch on its way. Just Ooh. Gets a piece of it. Strike one. Seventh inning here at the ballpark. 4-2 our score. And he pops it up back behind second base.
Ah, he ain't going anywhere.
And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Marlins leave one as they can't add to their 4-2 lead.
Not bad, not bad. They didn't do too bad last year. I think they won a division, I believe. And I don't remember if they lost in the ALCS or what happened. Yeah, they have definitely a stacked team. As you can see, I am a Marlins fan, but what are you going to do?
This was just a solo shot, but it definitely helped get this offense going.
Give me 1 second, man. Yeah, I wouldn't change my team for the world, but, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do.
They set the target in, and this finds the inside corner for strike one. One of the things that makes him so tough to hit, the ability to put his pitches right on the black.
Yeah, I mean, you watch the catcher's glove on some of these, and it literally does not move. That's how good his stuff is.
And the eighth inning begins with a flyout, quickly one away.
That's a disappointing final at bat there. You figure he probably won't get another shot at finishing off the cycle, but still a very good performance to say the least.
Miguel Cabrera comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one.
Getting that first pitch strike is so important against a guy like this. You have to be able to work ahead in the
game. Yeah, I mean, I was hoping they'd be better this year because, I mean, but every time they waste some money and get some good players, you know, it's they fucking, I don't know, they fall apart. 2012, they fell apart. I mean, they spent good money, new team and everything else, and all those all-stars just couldn't cash in with one another. I don't know, it just happens. What are you going to do? And same with last year, you know. Hopefully this year, you know, they got some solid guys. I mean, a young team. I mean, it's just gonna take some time. But it gets hard trying to defend your team to certain people. You know what I'm saying? I'm sure you have that feeling. Because the Blue Jays weren't really good till really last year. I mean, they've been building up, but it's not like. You know, the Cardinals or something.
Will stand in
or the Giants, they win the World Series every 3 to 5, or every, like, just about every year. Sorry, misspoke.
Both teams with 8 hits in this one. Chop foul over towards the coaching box. looking to put him away. Here's the 0-2. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Down in order go the Tigers, still down by a count of 4-2. Giancarlo Stanton gets another shot.
The big man, Stanton.
He hit a round tripper back in the fourth.
Giancarlo Stanton.
He's ready. Here's the first offering.
I got the ground out. Shit.
Iglesias to his left. He's there. Throw to first is in time for the first down.
You know, there's no such thing as a routine grounder with this guy. If you take your time, he's going to be safe. He'll be
yeah, I mean, as long as it's really just the concept of staying healthy. I mean, Jose Fernandez, I mean, he was coming off Tommy John surgery last year. And he got hurt a little bit. And, you know, it just happens, you know. Same with Stanton. He gets hurt every year, so I mean, we picked up Ichiro, I think, last year. So, I mean, he'll get some playing time. Yeah, I mean, as far as the Blue Jays go, but they are a good stacked team this year. I mean, they lost. I don't know why they didn't sign Price again. I don't understand that. I mean, you lost to the Red Sox. That's one thing I just don't understand. But Price has been in and out of teams for like the last 5 years. I mean, he hasn't had a, you know, good consistent home.
Toward shallow right. Martinez has it in his tracks. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Miami down in order, but they still lead this one 4-2.
But before the game is over, I was wondering, you got a PS4? And if so, do you want
to
go ahead and add me? So go ahead and play sometime or go to just chill?
Need him to get something going here.
Well, you know, he's been on base twice in this one already, so let's see if he can do it again.
Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Now time is called here as we'll get a trip to the mound. A.J. Ramos is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth.
Alright, I'll add you, I'll write your name down and write you and add you right after this. And then we can go to a chat sometime, or, you know, party chat. I play Black Ops, obviously this. Some sports games, you know, Madden and stuff. So, I mean, I have to get off here after this game, but nonetheless, I'll hit you up. And if you want to watch again, I mean, I'm going to try to start broadcasting like every night, because I'm doing my season on here, each individual day, so... I mean, I did all my spring training games and shit, so trying to get the season and stuff. And I do the road to the show and stuff on that. So I mean, if you want to check it out, and if you know some people that wanna watch, I mean, by all means, I'll do some commentary. And if I get some more people in here, I'll start giving away some, you know, PSN cards or something. If I can get a decent amount of people, you know, like 30, 40 people, I'll start giving PSN cards out. You know, the more I get, you know.
Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a cold strike.
But I'll definitely subscribe to you after this as well and keep you updated and shit.
Not the greatest at bat thus far as he misses that pitch in the dirt and falls behind nothing and two now.
You know, the big key to throw on the slider is knowing when to throw for a strike and then when to try to get a guy to chase out of the zone.
Yeah, but I mean, if you want to hit, like I said, I'm going to add you after this game, and if you want to watch again tomorrow night, I'll be broadcasting, let me see, I'd say about 5 o'clock Eastern, because I'm in the Eastern time zone, so 5 p.m. Eastern, and if you want to let other people know, and I'll do at least 1 to 2 games a day, so.
And taking in out there for the first down.
But anyways, do you play Black Ops or anything? Or Battlefield or something?
Difficult pitch to drive with any authority unless you're a guy like Matt Kemp. And this becomes a harmless flyout to right field.
Nick Castellanos will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base. Ooh. As they're down to their final two outs. Here's the first pitch slider that just tails out of the zone. It's ball one. And 2-0 as this one's taken low.
There we go.
Change out there for him, but he missed it. 2-1.
Boy, he's got that thing going good. It just takes a nosedive right at the end.
Line toward right center, and that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit.
Damn. Come on, fucking Ramos, don't pull this shit.
That old expression about needing a bloop and a blast. Well, that was hardly a bloop. That ball was stung pretty good.
But it is, yeah, I'm not that good at Black Ops either.
There's new life in that dugout.
Yeah, I mean, if you could watch your mouth, like, I mean, I'd be doing it every day. I mean, I get out of work around 7 o'clock at night, so fucking why not? I'll be doing it later on, I mean, like 7:30, 8 o'clock sometimes, but tomorrow during the weekends, you know, I'll be doing it normal times and shit, like 5:30, 5 o'clock, maybe earlier in the day. And I'll get it taken care of. And, you know. Just trying to get some, you know, more subscribers and shit. I'm not trying to make anything out of this YouTube thing, you know, but, I mean, why not? Fuck it. And if really you subscribe to me, I'm subscribing to you. That's how it works.
On to first, and he rolls the double play ball to end it here as this ball game is over.
Hey, how about two for the price of one to finish things off here? He gets the double play grounder here to dig himself out of trouble and picks up the save. Before we take our leave, time for a look at our final line score here in what turned out to be a close two-run victory.
Chen didn't do very good either. Yeah, two runs, it wasn't bad, but...
And gentlemen, one of the big keys here for the Marlins this afternoon was the play of this man, Giancarlo Stanton. Take a snapshot of that. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, look at the big man.
A couple of hits, but more importantly, that big home run, which really led his guys to this victory.
That was a fucking bomb of a shot. Alright, man, I don't know if you're still in here, but if you are, I want to thank you again for watching. I greatly appreciate it, of course. And, again, tell your friends, tell whoever know you if they watch YouTube, whatever, you know, the usual bullshit. And I'm going to go ahead and keep broadcasting, you know, day in, day out. And if I get enough people, I'm going to start giving shit away, you know. That's what it's going to come down to. And I'm going to keep broadcasting this game, do all the different playthroughs, I'll start doing that. But if there's nothing, I mean... I'm going to go ahead and do that. So with that being said, again, thanks for watching. I'll catch you tomorrow. And I'm going to go ahead and add you here in a couple of minutes. All right, man? Take it easy.